compare the fractions 4 sixths and 5 twelfths.
And I can go ahead and write those here. So we're comparing 4 sixths and 5 twelfths. So let's think about putting these fractions first on a number line. Here on my number line, I'm going to mark 0, and over here, I'm going to mark 1. Let's start with 4 sixths. Is 4 sixths close to 0? No. Let me think about 4 sixths compared to 1 half. 4 sixths is a little bit greater than 1 half, so I'll place 4 sixths on my number line just about right here. Now let's think about 5 twelfths. Is 5 twelfths close to 0? Not really. Let me think about 1 half. Is 5 twelfths close to 1 half? Yeah, it's just a little bit less than 1 half. So I will place 5 twelfths on my number line just about right here. So here I can see that 4 sixths is greater than 5 twelfths. Now I can also check that problem using my fraction tiles. So I'll get out my whole, and this also represents my number line, with 0 on this side and 1 over here. Now remember, I was comparing 4 sixths to 5 twelfths. So here are 4 1/6 pieces, and I determined that those were greater than 5 twelfths. So I can put 5 twelfths right here on top to compare whether 4 sixths is greater than 5 twelfths. And indeed, 4 sixths is greater than 5 twelfths.